I've got to tell you, it is Pete Price, and it is the Empire, and it is Peter Pan, and we've got Captain Hook, and he doesn't look like him right now, because the hook's gone. I'm glad that the hook's gone, because Louis Emerick, the hook is pretend, isn't it? Some kids actually thought...
Yeah, we went out before, and they were recoiling in terror, so I had to take it off and show them it wasn't real, you know.
You have gone from strength to strength with your career. I've got to mention two classics, one, Last of the Summer Wine, and two, Brookside, which you had the best storylines without any shadow of doubt.
I had some wonderful storylines, Pete, and I was very privileged and honoured to be a part of that. I mean, you know, you had the stalking with Jenny, you had the euthanasia story with the mother-in-law who had cancer and all like that, Living Wills, which were just sort of coming into prominence anyway in general life. And, you know, Phil Redmond always seems to have a knack of having his finger on the pulse in terms of storylines. I was very privileged and enjoyed all my stuff there.
I'm glad you mentioned Phil Redmond, because I've got to quote what you just said. We were on a ship and we were by the water, and he went, if Phil Redmond had been here, he would have walked across that.
Oh yeah, certainly I love
that line. I've got to mention Dorman in Benidorm.
Yes, Norman the Dorman in the upcoming series, which is going out in January, by the way. Yeah, I really made up about that, and it's funny because the part was just for a doorman, and then when I got it, my agent said, oh, come on, Louis Emerick with all his standing and all that, he deserves a name. So Darren Linton said, hey, okay, it's Norman. So that was it, but it's great. And lovely Tony Maudsley from Liverpool, who plays Kenneth, the gay crimper, lovely man, Tim Healy. So all my scenes were with them, and young Adam, who plays Liam, you know, the sort of gormless son. Terrific role.
I believe this is the first time at the Empire.
Pete, it is, and I am so made up. In nearly 30 years, it's my first time treading on the famous stage in my hometown, and that's just added extra sauce of, I don't know what you'd like to put, icing on the cake, if you like.
Can you imagine that feeling you're going to feel walking out the first time?
Oh, I'm trying to imagine it. I asked Sarah White, who played Bev and Brookie, what's it like? And she said, emotional. And I'm kind of expecting that. I mean, I don't know how it's quite going to hit me that first time in front of, you know, my home crowd in such a, you know, one of the most famous theatres in the world.
Do you mind being a baddie?
Oh, I love being a baddie. It's like, it's the old thing when they say pizza. They are the best parts, aren't they? You know, you can really go over the top with them. I've got to have some kids crying before
I leave.
Well,
I will mention, I won't mention their names, but I know a couple of baddies who hate getting booed. Can you believe it?
God, what are they like? If I don't get booed off that stage, then something's wrong.
And your family will be coming to see him. Have they seen you as Captain Hook?
Yes, my little boy saw me in... I'm a little girl, but my little boy Rio came up to Buxton, and he was very upset that Peter Pan beat me in the end, so I've said that this year Captain Hook's going to win. So I don't know how we're going to work that.
Ladies and gentlemen, a piece of history has just been made. We're changing the script from a historic piece of theatre.
Just for that one performance.
Just for that one performance. And then when he goes to the toilet, we then... Peter wins. It's going to be amazing.
Oh, they can't wait. They're loving it.
It's going to be great too, because you're at home, because people don't understand. It's all very well. Yes, you work. Of course you work. You've got to pay the bills. But being away, Buxton, it's not too far, but it's the fact that you're going to walk out that theatre and you're home.
Well, there was a couple of times, even though it's not that far, but it got snowed in, you know, and so I had to stay. And of course you stay, but there's nothing like being at home, doing something that you like, and then being able to go home every night. I mean, it's just going to be perfect this year, you know.
So what's your message to everybody out there? The bookings are already doing phenomenal. We're in Peter Pan. It is the Liverpool Empire. This is Captain Hook. And by the way, I love the wig. Love the wig. What's your message to everyone?
My message is come and see Peter Pan at the Empire, because you will be thrilled. But also, my aim is to scare the bejesus out of you. So that's what I'm going to do.
Louis Emerick. It's Peter Price saying thank you. I play, by the way, a camp pirate. And my name's Roger. I'm not going any further with that. Enjoy it at Christmas. Bye-bye.